There's a great feature in Excel called data consolidation, and it saves you having to go through and manually create lots of formulas. This tool will kind of do a lot of the grunt work for you. Now, there's two ways you can go about doing it. One is called consolidating data by position. The other is called consolidating data by category or labels. So let me show you the first way, and then I'll move on to the second way straight after. Now, the first way, consolidate by position, assumes that all of your source data is the same format. So if you look here, we've got week 1, week 2, week 3, and week 4. All the tables there are the same format. The figures are different, but that's the whole point. We're going to add up and get a total for all of these in the monthly summary sheet. So what we do first, you can choose just the cells where you want the formulas to go. You then go to the Data tab here and choose Consolidate over here. This dialog box is the control center. First thing you need to do is to choose what function you want to apply. So if you want totals, you'd leave it as sum. There's also all these other things in there if you wanted to use those at some other stage. You then just go through and choose all your references, which are the cell ranges from each of the sheets that you want to add up. You place your cursor in the reference box, then go to week 1, highlight all of week 1's figures, and add. You then go to week 2, you'll find the cell range is actually correct, so you can just add. Week 3, cell range is good, click add. Do the same for week 4, and add. So here, these are the four areas we're going to be adding up. Ignore this other stuff for now, that comes into play in just a minute. Click OK, and what you see here are the totals for your 4 weeks worth of data. Now there's no formulas behind here, it's just literally gone off, got the data, added it up, and put it in as a value. Now if you did want formulas, you can do that. Let me just delete that again. If I just repeat the process, so consolidate, your 4 sets of data are still here. I can create links down here. And what it does is it goes and collects the data, it brings it all in, but there's actually formulas behind here now, and it's grouped each cell of data over here. So if I click the plus sign to expand it, you can see the 4 totals that have come in, each one of which has a formula, and then the total is here. Let me just undo that and take you back to here. Now, quite often, your data is not consistent, especially if you sent an email out to people and said, could you send me your data? I need to get my totals together. Quite often what will happen is people will send it in all sorts of different formats. So I'm just going to hack this around a little bit. I'm going to maybe add some rows in here, just to sort of throw things out a little bit. Maybe on a different sheet, I'll move this whole section to a different spot entirely. Let's do the same for week 3. You know, things can be in a different order, all that kind of stuff. If you leave it up to each individual's preference, you'll get all sorts of different formats coming back. It doesn't matter, you can still use the consolidate feature, but you have to bring another element into play, and it's like this. Now for this second method to work, consolidate by category or label, you need to include the labels as well as the formula cells as part of your original selection. Because what it does is it goes through each of your cell ranges that you're about to select, and it matches based on the label. Now the first thing I need to do is to take all the existing data here, all the existing references, and delete them. And then rebuild the list. Put my cursor in the reference box. I'm going to go to week 1. Now I need to select all the data this time, including the labels, because it's matching on the labels. Add that in. Go to week 2. I might need to move the box here. Select all your data, including the labels. Add that in. Go to week 3. Do the same thing here. Add. And then week 4. Select all the original data, including the labels. And add. Now for this feature to work, matching by label or category, you need to say whereabouts those labels are. Now this particular range of data doesn't have any top labels, but it does have the left column labels. So I'm going to tick that. You could create the links again if you wanted to, I'm not going to bother. And you click OK, and it goes off, gets the data in exactly the same way, and puts the totals in here. If you've thought ahead and you've maybe created a template and sent it out, then your week 1, week 2, week 3, week 4 are going to be identical formats, in the same position every time, so consolidating becomes very easy. But if you leave people to their own devices and it comes back in all sorts of ways, shapes and forms, as long as the labels are consistent, so they're all spelt the same, and that requires you sometimes to go in and manipulate things so they are the same, you might need to spend a little bit of time just getting all the spellings consistent. When that's done, you can then consolidate by category. I hope you found this video useful. That's it for today.